considered shipwrights because the carpenters, they had to build the canneries so they was able to fish.
But in sailboat days, it was just horrible. That tent and everything would get wet, and you always wet. Little sweet stove to cook on.
And if you was above average, you could get a job next year. But if you fell below the average for a couple of years, and they didn't want you, you had to go with somebody else as a vote puller. And if you couldn't, you were just out. That's all. If there was people complaining about the conditions in the cannery or the safety in the boats or anything like that, and then they were out of a job, and then they had the blackball system.
We went out Monday morning, and we didn't come back till Saturday night. And if you didn't make it, you didn't make it. If the wind died down on you, that's where you stayed. We had no rollers, but we had to pull by hand. We had a tough life.
When I see a lot of boat heading in one direction, you know, and they drop the sail in a hurry, you know, I know there's fish over there. That's a good indicator when those few sailboats drop their sail down in a hurry. Mm-hmm. And I know a lot of fish, and then I go to the same place, and sure enough, a lot of fish. Then I throw my net out in here. Boatload too.
Thank you. gangster, what they call run money.
Mm-hmm.
Some of them hung nets, some of them was on scow, and mud gang, they would launch these scows, put them down, you know, make the waves. And another gang was putting in boats, launching the boats,
mm-hmm.
and also pulling them up in the fall, you know, and then loading the salmon.
We used to unload ships for what they call $100 run money in the spring, and then we load the salmon back on the ship for another $100 run money. So that's $200 for spring, unloading the ship and loading the ship with salmon.
Price of fish is about 6 cents a fish.
Mm-hmm. Not, you know, my dad told me when I first started fishing here in Bristol Bay, they were on monthly salary, and still the fishermen try to beat one another. Just imagine, on salary. So they finally got paid so much to fish this. First going off, they got 2 cents for a whole salmon, 5 cents a salmon. On Eat Cup Carry. One time I laid out the line and then I drifted in. I got on a bar and all of a sudden water was coming from both sides of the boat, and I told my partner, grab a bucket. But we were only stuck for a few minutes and the tide took us across the bar into deep water. That was saved. That's about the closest call I had. 17 fishermen got drowned during fishing season, and one deckhand of a tugboat, I think, 18 altogether drowned one summer.
Look, man, it's just white all over. Just white. We're right on hit the edge of that bar. And just a few minutes, the boat started filling up with water. I got half of the water. We lost all the oars. The current runs crossways on that bar. And we made it over. It got good then, we had to bail out then. That, you know, once you hit top that bar there. Mm. It was blowing, we used to fish, you know. Try to catch fish then. Remember when blowing pretty hard, a big southeast came with the one silver capsized outside of Econ there. Capsized. He just hung on to his nest and this captain was close.
But most of them never trimmed the boat right, so too much fish in the stern, the swamp. You know, they have them. And then, like I said, I didn't have life preservers. So I don't know why. And when a boat swamp and then the boat roll over upside down and they had nothing to hang on to. But the last 2 years I've fished at Eacock in the sailboat, I asked net boys why he would drill holes on the bow and under the stern. He said they're going to run a line all around the bottom of the boat. So if the boat do capsize, fishermen have something to hang onto it. If they had that line under the sailboat, they probably would have saved a lot of lives.
Were most of the fishermen pretty happy with that kind of fishing?
I get a kick trill out of sailors, especially when that mast and bend like. He showed it on TV, the one boat that had this mast bend.
So about how many knots do you think you're going when that mast bends?
Oh, I don't know. The boat I had, I'd done pretty good. I used to pass in Alaska a pack of sailboats. I was an Eacock boat, but rather, the Alaska Packers boats were kind of bulky, they didn't sail too good like Eacock boats did.
wouldn't give us.
In the former days, it was a gentleman's fishery. Everybody respected the other guy, and if he set in his nets, they give him some room. But now, today, it's just like an insane asylum down there.
It was better than it is now. He didn't have any...
I'm retired, but I tell the fishermen, go back to sail. Wind power is cheap. The way it looked like that, and going to turn, make a landing.